do this again. Just today, we're going to do it again. So, the only problem is, I've got to find the guys. They're missing. It's really sad. They left me up here alone. Couple announcements. We're going to be in here. So I'm glad you found it. For those of you that found it, good, tell the other people. This is an announcement for those that don't need it. Maybe you've seen the announcement they have down at the Iowa Job Service. It's a little handout. It says, you know, adults learn to read through the Iowa Literacy Program. It's a handout. We don't know who it's for. So this announcement is for people already here. One other thing, it does cost us a little more money to do the show here. I hope you don't mind. We're at the same price, but you gotta buy your own snack.
However,
the snack people are really nice, and they're retired, and they're destitute, and they make a lot of money off of cookies, let me tell you. So I hope you don't mind that, because you don't have any choice. So tonight we have a show that will go till 3 a.m. The rate things are going. But really, I want to thank you guys for making it possible for us to move. We've been billing each of your phone bills for this move. We had professional movers do it. You'll know why your bill is larger next month. But thanks for coming and seeing us every week. And those of you who are new, well, you were supposed to pay more. But no, really, thanks for being a great audience. And I want to say this now before the show in case, you know, you never know. So where are my people? They're out there. What are they doing?
Majorette.
Cheerleader. Okay.
So is it Marcy, she's our girl, if she can't do it. Yeah.
care if you are that sensitive. That guy's tie is better than yours.
I spent 3 days picking this tie out. I went to 15 stores. It's your favorite color, dear. Look.
I taught you how to iron better than this. What is this? Look at you. Pick up your pants.
I don't know.
Well, your socks match. That's an improvement.
Oh, I meant to put different colored ones on.
No, I meant they are the same color.
Oh, God. But this tie. Nobody turns you on so much this time.
Sam, here it is. Another Friday night. Got time. Got money. Got no date. Well, same as every Friday night.
Shouldn't be a problem if you have your money.
Hang on.
genre, a type of fiction, a type of book. Anyone? Western, I heard first.
Romance.
A Western romance.
Western.
Just one is fine. A Western.
The Dark Knight was really dark. But what could he do? So they rode off into the big sunset. But it wasn't very bright. So they had to choose another activity. And what they chose to do instead was cowpoking.
Cowpoking.
Absolutely
the most fun
that they had ever had. So they started. And it was incredible. They poked every cow.
These are movers, but question is, who are they? Who are these two men?
Politicians.
They're politicians. Where are they?
The White House.
India.
They're at the White House. Where in the White House?
The basement.
In the basement? Who wants bathroom? Who wants basement? Okay, you're in the bathroom. In the White House. Bathroom number 16. Have fun.
I'll get these clean in a few minutes if I keep this up.
I don't think I should have used the bowl cleaner for a mouthwash. I seem to be reacting kind of funny to the bowl cleaner.
I know what you mean. I got it in my eye.
These urinals are kind of low.
That's nothing. I can't even see mine.
And the thing is, I don't
don't know why they put urinals on the balcony. You really have to watch what's going on around here.
Well, I'm finished. If I can just find the paper, I'm out of here.
Group of people, very friendly group. But where are they? Excuse me? Who knows where that is? It has to be, you know, in England. What? They're at a carnival. Lemmy.
Oh, Dad, I want some cotton candy.
No, I don't like the heavy stuff.
Oh, come on, Daddy.
Shut up, Dad. There's nutritious stuff over here. Oh, man. Yeah, you can have some popcorn, some nice cheese sandwiches.
Cheese sandwiches?
Look at that yellow bill over there. God, is he big?
Can we get him some peanuts? Okay, come on, Daddy. Yeah. Peanuts for the elephant.
Film's a little, you know, old and everything. Okay, the first line is where Marcy's kind of warming up over there, and she's trying to kind of throw it out there, but she kind of missed and hits Dan in the head. So Betsy's kind of holding up Stan, and Paul there is kind of looking for Stan's face down the floor. Okay, next. Stan always takes a loss really hard. And the other team wasn't very humble, you know? And so anyway, next slide, please. This is great. What a team effort, collective consciousness and everything. They're all going after the same ball. And think that they actually catch it in a group with their mouths. All right, next slide. This is great. We try to keep our team spirit up, you know. And so they're really a happy group here. And the problem is they all ate some capital food prior to going out for the game there. And they're little sluggish here. All right, next one. This is a new way of sliding into home. You notice how Betsy kind of goes sort of like crawling there and everything. And the thing is, the team that's getting the personnel is the same team that's doing the sliding. It's a new concept here. Okay, next slide, please. Off the fly ball that they all were trying to catch. And the team just isn't very understanding. Okay, next slide, please. I don't remember this slide at all. This is it. Coach was kind of angry at the loss of the game here, and the team was just playing dumb. Okay, next slide, please. They're a very close-knit group. Okay, next slide, please. These guys, when they lose a game,
that'll kill us if he gives us alcohol. You.
Sour cream.
That's bread. Closer. At least it's lactate. Pizza! Pizza!
Sour cream on my circuit boards. I want dip with my chips.
Now we really need a leg of your help. Because we're at that point in the show,
Italy,
where we need a little help from you. We need a day in the life of somebody's a day in the life. Maybe way back, something really nice happened. Maybe you were like your first kiss. Maybe it's the worst of day, most embarrassing moment of your life. Either way, we'd like to know some volunteer from the audience. Give us a day in the life when that was embarrassing, leading up to a whole embarrassing moment, or your first kiss. Could be the same thing. Most embarrassing moment, first kiss, the same thing. Okay? Oh, another thing. For today, since we moved, anyone got a really nice moving story? The day they moved and their mother broke? Anything. No, not everyone at the same time, please.
She raised her hand right there.
Oh, we heard that. I was scratching my head there before. Come on.
Yeah. Anybody?
She's got one right here. She's got a great one. She won't tell it.
Well, will you tell about it? Most embarrassing moment or first kiss.
Okay, everybody put your hands over your eyes and let her tell it. We won't look. Go ahead.
What do you got? Embarrassing moment, first kiss?
I've got a good one. I've got a good one. My sister. My sister.
She could be her sister.
Who wants to hear her sister's most embarrassing moment?
Yeah.
If it's really embarrassing, we'll send her the tape. Okay, let's hear it.
She lives in London, and she lives on the outskirts of London and commutes in London every day.
I like it a lot. This is preposterous.
Okay.
Wait, Jess, could you stand up and face these?
up, saying, well, she never washes her face, she doesn't meditate, she gets out of bed, onto the train. She goes to work, she has a bag full of washcloth, hair dry, you know, does herself when she gets to work. This morning it was raining, so she gets up, grabs an umbrella, tucks it under her arm, marches off to work. She's lived in this area for 10 years, so everyone knows her, you know, the fishmonger knows her, greengrocer knows her, you know, little stores there. They all know, everyone's looking at her. Funnily, it's sort of like a 10-minute, quarter of an hour walk. So she's sort of going, so I got curlers in my hair, and they're hanging down. She gets to the station, and there's a mirror, you know, a glass thing. She looks in the mirror. She's got under umbrella under there. She looks at herself. She's got her underwear hanging off.
What did she do then?
What did she do? Well, she grabbed them and put them in her pocket, but she still has to walk down that road. People still remember.
I think she has to go back home this year. That's exciting. Thank you. Next week it's your mouth and beer. None. Okay. We're off. Jenny Lee is on.
Oh, yeah.
Jenny Lee is going to sing some songs here. This is her second arrival. However, she's not on her feet. She must be out there. Yeah.
I'm going to sing for you tonight, and the first thing my song that I'm going to sing for you is a song from Camelot called The Simple Joys of Maidenhood. This song has very special meaning to me, mainly because it is one of the greatest stresses of my life. When I was a young girl, my parents used to listen to me sing with all of the Broadway record albums we had and everything, and so they thought that I had a nice voice. And so whenever company would come over, they would drag me out, and I would have to sing a cappella in front of these people, and just, you know, sing these songs. And of course, you'd see them all sit down like this, you know, just waiting to hear, you know, somebody's kid. And usually, it turned out pretty much okay. I mean, most of them were somewhat pleasantly surprised, but the trauma of that, and then quite often I would have to sing for them when they were reading the newspaper or having little conversations and entertain them in the car. And so I just developed this incredible stress where it got to be like pulling teeth just to get me to sing for anyone. And I tried to work through this. My biggest, my first step was at the end of teacher training. We had a little talent show. And I told this sad tale in front of all of the ladies, and then proceeded to sing the song for them a cappella, which was a huge step for me, but of course I was rounding then, so. So now, this is it. My first time in public, I'm actually going to sing this in front of people, but I'm not doing it a cappella, I have music this time. So if I get through this, then this will be a great victory for me, so please clap anyway.
Genevieve, Saint Genevieve,
back and forth like beads in a bazaar. St. Genevieve, I've run away, eluded them and fled. And from now on, I intend to pray to someone else instead. Oh, Genevieve, St. Genevieve, where were you when my youth was sold? Dear Genevieve, sweet Genevieve, shan't I be young before I'm old?
Day in the life of her sister.
and chips, fish and chips. I want it. You okay today, Kim?
You lost something?
You want fish and chips today, dear? Here, have some vinegar. You got $2, Irving? We take dollars now.
You got the station right. And that's about how she looks in the morning.
Now we have a little thing we did last week called Playbook. only one of the people gets to read the play, and the other one has to make it up as they go along. So I have to find out if one of the players is ready. One. I need three sentences from the crowd. Three unrelated sentences. Mary had a little lamb.
Fuzzy Wuzzy was a bear.
Wait a minute. Only one. Mary had a little lamb.
Checks in the mail.
That's the ketchup I heard. And your check's in the mail. Your check's in the mail. You guys are too nice. Okay, so we're going to tell you a little story with these three sentences. One in the beginning, one in the middle, one at the end. The first one, Mary had a little lamb, with the obvious segue to pass the ketchup. Next time, work a little harder. The third one, your check's in the mail. Got it? Yeah. Okay, I'm going to do this anyway. First sentence, Mary had a little lamb. She was normally vegetarian. But they cooked it up so nice and they put a little parsley on it, a watercress on the side, you know. And she was at her mother's place. Her mother was going, honey, I made it for you. So she looked down at the little victim and said, that's a ketchup. Anyway, so her mother was really happy with her, and since she was eating the food her mother wanted her to eat, and so she thought she'd say, hey, Mom, remember that guy I wanted to marry? She goes, yeah, I remember that guy. Yeah, yeah. That kind of kind of revolutionary guy? Yeah, Mom. Yeah, he's coming. He's coming to here to see you again, to try and marry me again. Okay? But there's only one thing, Mom. I want you to be nice to him this time. And the other thing is, I'm really not sure how he's going to get here. It's really making me nervous. I haven't heard from him. How he's going to make it here, it's really distressing. And I'm really nervous about it. And you don't like him either. I'm just really nervous. The phone rings. Okay? Turns out her boyfriend, she's in the Soviet Union. He's in Czechoslovakia. The phone rings. Her mother goes over to it, picks it up. Yes? Oh, yeah, yeah, sure, great, great, great. Oh, yeah, I've heard that before. Honey, she says to her daughter, your check's in the mail. Okay. Now we have a little scene where only one person gets the book and the other one has to make it up. And it has a title. The title is Rodeo and Juliet.
Oh, Romeo, Romeo, wherefore art thou, Romeo? Deny thy father, refuse thy name, or if thou wilt not, but sworn, my love, and I'll no longer be a Capulet.
You're one of them English gals, ain't you? I'm much admired of the way you talk there, but you're a little confused. Name's Rodeo. Rodeo Dan, the Mustang Man. You got any broncos you want broke, you come to me.
Tis but thy name that is my enemy.
Well, I kind of hoped we were going to be friends.
What's in a name? That which we call a rose by any other name would smell as sweet.
Well, I'm okay.
Romeo, doff thy name, and for thy name, which is no part of thee, take all of myself.
I'm getting to like the way you talk. We're going to get along just fine. Let's you and me go out stepping.
What man art thou that thus be screened in? a knight, so stumble us on my counsel.
Well, I thought we'd kind of established that.
My ears have yet not drunk 100 words of thy tongue's uttering, yet I know the sound. Art thou not Romeo, and a Montague?
No, no, Montague's the car I came in. Chevy Montague. Rodeos. Rodeo.
How camest thou hither? Tell me, and wherefore? The orchard walls are high and hard to climb, and the place death, considering who thou art, if any of my kinsmen find thee here.
Well, now, as far as getting here, I mean, I was just driving down the road in my Montague there, and I saw the light coming out through your door, and coincidentally through your nightgown, and I just kind of... Clumb up on the roof of my car, and clumb over the wall, and clumb up on the balcony, and here I am. Now, what was it you were saying about your relatives?
If they do see thee, they will murder thee.
Fundamentalists, are they? Preaching family, huh? I can kind of tell by the way you talk.
I would not for the world they saw thee here.
Sounds okay with me.
By whose direction found thou this place?
Well, I saw your phone number. I probably shouldn't tell you where.
Do not swear at all, or if thou wilt, swear by thy gracious self, which is the god of my idolatry, and I'll believe thee.
Preachers, I told you. No, I'll keep my mouth closed. I don't cuss much, ma'am, unless I've been drinking.
Sweet good night. This bud of love by summer's ripening breath may prove a beauteous flower when next we meet. Good night. Good night. As sweet repose and rest come to thy heart that is in within my breast.
Does this mean you don't want to go dancing tonight?
Just one minute, I can play with you for a little bit before. shower.
Well, okay. Oh, it's so wonderful. Oh.
But Michael, why don't you sit and play with it? Because I'll be out of my shower just one more minute.
Where's your breakfast, dear?
Oh, goodness, it is a little late. Well, I'll be in just for one more minute, so maybe I'll just have it.
Now, don't forget the cable man's coming today.
Oh, really? Well, I'll be out of the shower shortly, so. Very good pancakes.
Miss Penn, dear.
Miss Penn? Well, I'm in the shower. I mean, I'll be out shortly. Just one. Oh, well, Miss Penn. Well, good morning, Miss Penn.
Good morning, sir. I'm sorry, but I really have some papers you must sign.
Hey, now, I'll be out in just one minute. I mean, no, but, well, good Lord, this is unbelievable.
Sir, you know, it's just important that you sign this thing, because otherwise that merger will never go through.
Well, okay, but, Penn, Miss Penn, yes. How clever of you. Well, I'll just sign it, although I'm going to be out in just one minute. Time is creeping on. Mm-hmm. Okay, thank you. I'll be out shortly.
I have some others. There's some dictation you must give today.
Oh, well, all right. Can't we wait a little? Oh, is that morning paper?
Yes. Yes, sir.
I'll be out in just one more minute, actually.
Yes, sir. You know, it's just imperative that we take care of all this business today. Just don't know. Oh.
Nothing too serious.
Hello? Yes. Yes, yes, yes. No, it's not his office, but yes, I... Yes? Oh, sir?
Yes, Miss Penn?
It's Mr. Elvaker. He really needs to speak to you.
But I'm in the shop.
No, but he's called twice.
Okay, okay, let me take it. Would you go to the towel?
Yes, I do.
Right. Oh, sir? I'll be out in just one minute. What is this? Well, it is a little late, I know, but I'm in my shop. XYZ's down tonight and Winter goes to 80's cell. No, no, the merger's not going through. He can take his vacation this week. No, Smith has to be here next week. Absolutely. I'll be in very, very shortly. Yes, thank you. Thank you, Miss Penn.
You're welcome, sure. Now,
what is that you need me to write?
Oh, I don't know.
The cable man's here, dear.
The cable man? But I'm in the shower. I'll be out in just one more minute. Just, can't be wait one minute.
Oh, please. So fun. A television set in the bathroom? These are weird people. Oh, I'm sorry, ma'am. Lady out there, where do you want this?
Sure.
Oh, I found the sofa.
Oh, I didn't know anything was going on in here.
Help me out for just one minute. One moment.
This cable man needs some installation instructions, please.
Oh, for the television?
Yes.
Oh, well, it's the boy that wants it, really, yes. Now, Benji, can you tell him where the... yes. Put it right there.
Daddy, I don't...
Well, it's for him. Put it right in the front there.
Right here, huh?
A little higher. He's growing. That's about right. That's perfect.
But he can't reach it.
It's okay. He'll get a chair. It's fine. No, there's a typographical error in the second paragraph.
Oh, okay.
Finished shaving. Come in the shower.
Daddy?
Oh, hi, darling.
I'd like you to meet my new boyfriend.
Well, how delightful.
This is Lewis. Lewis?
Lewis, I'm so glad to see you. Lewis, Lewis.
Well, nice to meet you, Mr. Waddington.
Charming, charming. Have a seat, have a seat. Miss Penn, Miss Penn. Lewis wants to sit down. I'll be out of the shower in just one more minute.
Does he ever come out of the shower?
Really, sir?
must leave now. I've got so many things to take care of.
Well, it is a little late.
Yes, it is. We're running very
late. I'll be out there in just 1 minute.
Yes, sir.
We're going off to a party now, Daddy.
Going off? Oh,
well, have a wonderful time. Don't be late, Lewis. I'll be out of the shower when you come back.
Nice to meet you, Mary.
Oh, hello, darling.
Hi. Benji, time for bed.
Listen to your mother.
Go right now, right now.
Very late.
I tell you, it's been a long day. I'm really tired. I think I'm going to go up too.
Oh, really? Okay. I'll be up in just a minute. Oh. Or maybe just one more minute.
Rendition of a small group of experts. The big question, though, is what? I've forgotten what they're experts about. They're experts about St. Patrick's Day. Now, bear in mind, you can have this, but we're doing it next week. St. Patrick's Day. Mermaid, I heard.
Yes.
Come back, Nick. Ayurveda. After this, so don't evaporate.
Okay, so I'm going to sing two songs for you. These don't have any stories to go with them. Actually, the only story is, please God, let me remember the words. The first one is from a show, a fairly new show called Les Miserables, Les Mis, which I was fortunate enough to see at Hampshire Auditorium, and it's incredible. So I'll try to do some justice. This is the most beautiful song from that show called On My Own. I'd like to be on my own, so please sit down. Story that you probably all know, which I'm not sure that Leonard Bernstein knew it at the time, but he was probably writing about heaven on earth or Fairfield or something like that. It's called Somewhere.
Little scene from Stan.
Thank you. Thank you.